We will get a new look at Assassin's Creed Valhalla on July 12th, and I would be shocked if this wasn't a gameplay deep dive. But that will just be the tip of the iceberg, because we should also likely expect the new Far Cry, and it seems like Ubisoft is already teasing that with the short video they released to promote this event. So I want to take a look at that and just everything else we can expect from this sort of Ubisoft Direct. A like on the video would be super appreciated, and let's go. Instead of early June, Ubisoft will hold their yearly E3 press conference on July 12th, called Ubisoft Forward, a fully digital showcase with exclusive game news, reveals, and more. Stay tuned. And I would not be surprised if they delayed it 1 month because they had to change their whole plan for the year, because while maybe a little easier than a physical event, a digital event is of course completely different. But that should not make it less exciting. I would maybe say that this might be one of the most exciting Ubisoft press conferences ever, because they have so many games that they plan to release. And we discussed it many times before here on the channel that they plan to release 5 AAA games before April 2021, and Ubisoft did not shy away from that schedule yet, actually saying that everything is still on track. So this includes Watch Dogs Legion, and I briefly just want to go over everything here in this video, but I will also do like an in-depth prediction video a little later. No, but Legion, we will totally see that game again in all its glory during this July 12th stream, and the rumor now is that it will debut alongside the PlayStation 5 and Xbox Series X, as Video Game Chronicle once again notes in their article. So that means that we will likely see next-gen footage of Watch Dogs Legion during this stream. The new game from the Assassin's Creed Odyssey creators will also be here, Gods and Monsters, and it will be more than a year by that point since we saw this small teaser trailer, so time for a proper gameplay reveal just to get a sense of what this game is actually all about. The same goes for Rainbow Six Quarantine, that also only had a teaser trailer last year. I'm sure we will see more from that, and I'm curious if they will change the name, because it might be a little too on the nose right now in this current situation. Either way, they also still plan to release that one before April 2021, and it's likely slated for early 2021. So February or March. And Ubisoft of course also has a ton of big games that are not AAA but that still need to come out soon. One of them is Roller Champions, the free-to-play sort of Rocket League sports game that I actually quite liked at E3 last year. And Just Dance will of course also have some sort of weird sequence during the presentation. And of course one of the highlights will be Assassin's Creed Valhalla. And if the other E3s are any indication, we will likely see that big gameplay walkthrough, have Ashraf Ismael, the creative director, share even more details on the game, and hopefully we get a trailer that showcases some awesome moments throughout the story. Yeah, it will be way more than we have at this point, but the question of course is, will we now really have to wait till July 12th to see new footage? I reached out to Ubisoft and they would not say yet, but I would really be shocked if this was going to be the case, because then why announce the game now? It makes very little sense if the next moment that you want to talk about it is going to be 2 months from now. So yes, I totally think we will get something before that, especially because the previous trailer is now currently sitting at double the amount of dislikes than likes. And of course, releasing a actual gameplay trailer will like help people forget. So I think we will see something before that, but it's not 100% confirmed. What we at least know is that we will get new Assassin's Creed Valhalla info on July 12th. And we also have Benoit, the game director on the game, saying save the date. So he's hinting at Assassin's Creed Valhalla stuff as well. And I would not be surprised if we hear the release date during that show too. Currently, there are rumors about it being October 16th, thanks to some stores having that date first before they changed to Holiday 2020. And by the way, before I forget, if you want a chance to win this game or another 2020 game of your choice, then totally follow the link in the pinned comment and be sure you are a subscriber of the channel before you enter this giveaway. So good luck, and I by the way reached out to the winner of my previous May giveaway, Fight a Mill. So yes, AZ Valhalla, Watch Dogs Legion, and Gods and Monsters will already be enough reason for me to watch, but I expect way more. Jason Schreier on Twitter said he would be surprised if we did not see the Avatar game that the Division studio Massive is currently working on. Good to note that this is a different team from the Division, and they started back in early 2017. so even before Assassin's Creed Valhalla. So they should be pretty far in development, and the first new movie, Avatar 2, should be out at the end of next year, if it doesn't get pushed like everything else. So we could see the first footage, or just a teaser, anything would be awesome. Will we see Beyond Good and Evil 2 again, or something on Skull and Bones? I'm not 100% sure about that, because those games are for 2021 at the earliest. Now, I think the biggest spotlight during Ubisoft Forward will be on Far Cry 6, and Jason already earlier shared that the two unannounced games from Ubisoft would be AZ Valhalla and a new Far Cry, so Far Cry 6, or whatever it will be called, is planned for early 2021, and this July show would be a perfect timing to announce it. And well, actually, I think that Ubisoft is already teasing it in this, like, Ubisoft Forward teaser video. Because I immediately looked at the background that Ubisoft was using for this announcement, and it looks like Far Cry to me. I first thought that this might be the new setting already, because there are two things that jump out: the statue in distance, and a plane that is landing at the end. And this statue could very well be the Joseph Seed statue in Far Cry 5. We actually have IWasCuddles on Reddit, who jumped into Far Cry 5 after I speculated about this being Far Cry related, and made this shot that looks very similar to what Ubisoft is using. So does this mean that what they are using is indeed Far Cry 5? High chance, actually. But then there are still two big questions left. One, what is that plane? Because I don't remember a huge white plane in Far Cry 5. And also, why is Ubisoft using a Far Cry 5 background to announce their E3-like stream? Like, apart from the rumors, we really don't know that Ubisoft plans to launch a new Far Cry game in early 2021, but this totally hints at that. Otherwise, why use the Far Cry 5 world? They have so many open worlds, like, they could have picked Watch Dogs Legion and showed London instead. So I would not be surprised if this maybe hints at something. I mean, we destroy the statue of Joseph Seed in Far Cry 5 that you likely see here in the distance, and, like, it's still there, so it should be destroyed. And in Far Cry New Dawn, it's not this big white statue anymore, but more like a large totem with smoke coming out of it. And you see an amazing comparison here from AstroSif, and I will link to his full video in the video description. But yeah, you likely agree, right, that the thing that we are seeing in Far Cry New Dawn is not what was shown in the Ubisoft Forward announcement. So I would not be surprised if this maybe hints at an alternative reality, or maybe the actual reality, and maybe the bombs at the end of Far Cry 5 never really went off, but that instead the army came who first could not reach Montana, and that might be the plane that we see landing. But yeah, I agree that it's weird, because they just did a whole sequel that basically confirmed that the nukes did indeed hit and how it changed the map and other parts of the US. But I always liked reading theories after the Far Cry 5 ending about how we were drugged and that the bombs did not really hit, that were just, like, hallucinating, and how in the end it was all kind of left in the middle. But yeah, it would be weird if Ubisoft now says that it was all fake, right? Or maybe this tease means that the game takes place during the Far Cry 5 era, so before the bombs went off. That would be a possibility. Or maybe I'm just overanalyzing it, and this just means that something Far Cry related is going to happen during Ubisoft Forward, and that is why they use this Far Cry 5 backdrop. And of course, I'm all ear. Drop your theories in the comments down below. I cannot wait to read them. And I'm curious if they will already tease it, like we saw these weird teasers before Far Cry 5 that already gave us a glimpse at the weird setting that they ended up with. And they also gave a heads up that Far Cry New Dawn would be part of the Game Awards stream. So I'm really curious to see what the setting will be, and this will be one of those big announcements that we talked about on Sunday, where I went over everything that we can expect this summer. It's going to be really, really awesome. And if you want to see that video, it is on the channel, or you can watch it via the pop-up that appears now on the screen. Also interesting is that this Thursday, Ubisoft will do their big financial call that I will live react to on twitch.tv/yourraptor. And the link to that is in the pinned comment, because it always reveals interesting stuff about their future. So now it could be about upcoming games like Assassin's Creed Valhalla, maybe Far Cry or Watch Dogs. like. I will keep you up to date here on the channel, of course, as well. So subscribe to miss nothing. Like the video to support the channel. And totally check out my recent Valhalla video on a new season pass mission and how mythology will work in the game. For now, though, I will speak to you next time, and goodbye.